Similarly, in the second spotting or second spot, you will get a microscope. In this microscope, one slide will be there. So after observing that slide, you have to give the answer of these questions. For example, first is identify that a given slide, which one slide is there. So first of all, you have to identify that this slide is there. Basically, in second specimen, you will get either the testes or the ovary slide. So first of all, you have to see which slide it is. After that, you have to give answer that it is a testes slide or it is a TS of ovary. After that, in second question, you have to draw a well-labeled diagram. In the examination, when you are on spotting, at that time, no need to use any type of pencil because it will take time. Because for every spot, you will get hardly 5 minutes to complete it. So that is why there is no need to draw a neat and clean diagram, only rough diagram with labeling. It is compulsory. So with label, you have to draw the diagram. After that, you have to write one significant feature that we can easily give. In third one, it will be a slide of a cell division. So whatever the different stages of cell division, that slide you will get, only one slide will be there. So that stage you have to identify, and after that you will give these answers. So first of all, you have to identify that which stage it is. After that, one significant feature of that slide, and after that we have to draw the diagram. In the fourth one, we have to identify the disease causing organism. So either it will be a plasmodium, it will be a trichophyton, or it will be a plasmodium. So these type of organism, either in the form of a slide or a specimen, you will observe or you will get. Then you have to give, first of all, identify this specimen. After that, you have to name the disease that is caused by that organism, and then you have to write 2 symptoms for this disease. We are skipping the fifth one. In six, first of all, you have to observe this type of diagram. So you have to identify this, which what we call this chart. So this chart is a pedigree analysis. So you have to answer the second question, shown trait to recessive or dominant. So this trait, whatever it is showing, it is recessive or trait or dominant, sorry. In the third question, you have to write the genotype of the first generation. So these are the few questions that you will get from this specimen. In the last one, you will get the specimen of an organism that is adapted for different type of habitat. For example, either it will be for the aquatic or for the xerophyte. So first of all, the given specimen adapted for which type of environment, then you have to write either it is xerophyte or it is aquatic. Then you have to write 3 adaptive features that is helping him for this habitat, for living in that habitat. So these type of specimens you will get. Now we will see what type of specimen you will get and how we have to recognize that.